I trust you guys. You will do it, right? Okay. Leave the answer down below in the comment and let me know. So that way, I know you did it. So in the previous video, I showed you guys the special binomial products. So in this video, I would like to show you guys how to do it backwards. And that is, how do we factor? Here, we'll be talking about the factoring formulas that you need, especially when we have these situations. Notice we have two terms. Starting with the first one, a squared minus b squared, we will get a minus b times a plus b. So notice this is the difference of two squared formula, and last time we have seen that if you multiply this out, you will get this. And that's how you can prove the formula, okay? Now, for the next one, we have a squared plus b squared. This right here, in fact, it's not factorable. Technically, not factorable with real numbers, but usually just don't do anything with this. Leave it, okay? And some books, they may use the term prime, meaning not factorable. Continue, for the third one, we have a difference of two cubes. The formula for this is a minus b, and then times a squared plus ab, and then plus b squared. Now, notice, if it's a minus, first we'll have a minus, and then you change the sign to a plus. And the last term right here, it's a plus. Another thing to notice is that there is no 2. This is not the result of a special product. It does look like it, but there's no 2. Now, for the last one, if we have the sum of two cubes, this right here is actually factorable, and we will get the following for the answer. We get a minus b, and then multiply with, sorry, we get a plus b. I was looking at this. No. If this is a plus, this will be a plus, and then this right here will be a minus. And the last term is also going to be a plus. So, just like that. These are the formulas that we need. Now let's take a look at some examples. And if you want to take a screenshot right now, here's your chance. Anyways, let's go ahead. Now for the first one, we have 36x squared minus 25. This is how we do it. Notice we have a squared and that's a minus. So let's open two sets of parentheses with squares on the outside. Then we are going to ask ourselves, what square gives us 36? 6. Use positive 6, okay? And then we need to get x squared, so we need the x right here. Then what square will give us 25? The answer for that is 5. Now we are ready because we have the a squared minus b squared, and we can use this formula. And the answer will be a minus b, which is 6x minus 5, and then times a plus b, right from the formula, so 6x plus 5. So for the factoring, you want to end up with like two factors multiplying, and you should always check, can you do more? Well, they don't have any common factors, so this is the most that we can do, and you leave it like this. Don't multiply it out. You could multiply it out to check the answer. If you multiply it out, you should get this back, and that means you get it right. But for factoring, you want to leave this for your answer. Now, for the next one, we have x to the fourth power minus 81. Fourth power, well, it's square square. So we can do the following. Open two sets of parentheses with squares on the outside. So even though we don't have the fourth power formula, but this is what we can do. Then right here, we will have to ask ourselves, what square will give us x to the fourth power? As we mentioned it, it's going to be x squared. And then to get the 81, we need 9. 9 squared gives us 81. Now, by looking at this, we have a squared minus b squared, so we can use the first formula. So we are going to get x squared minus 9 times x squared plus 9. Now, we have to ask ourselves, can we do more? For the first one, notice we have x squared minus 9. Well, 9 is the what? It's the same as 3 squared. So if we pay attention to this part right here, we can look at this as x squared minus 3 squared. And in fact, we can continue. Well, for this right here, I'm just going to leave it because that's x squared plus 3 squared. But notice this right here is not factorable. You don't need to write down not factorable for this. Just leave it like that. Don't do anything with it. But for the first parentheses here, we can factor it. We will get x minus 3 times x plus 3. So for the blue part, we can use the first formula. But for the second one, just leave it. Just write it down, x squared plus 9 along with the answer. So this right here will be it. This is the most that we can do. Now, for number 3, we have 8x cubed minus 27y cubed. So it's a difference of 2 cubed situation, but we have to get ready first. So right here, let's open two sets of parentheses, but with third power on the outside right here. Now, what to the third power will give us 8? The answer for that is 2. And then we also need the x, so we can get the x to the third power. Then for this, what to the third power will give us 27? 3, right? Okay, 3, and then we also need a y. Now we're ready. This is the a, this is the b. So the first factor is a minus b, which is 2x minus 3y. And then the second factor, we have to square the a, so we have to do this squared. 2 squared is 4, so this right here will be 4. And then x squared, we get x squared. Continue with the plus ab, so that means we multiply this and that. 2 times 3 is 6, and then we have the x and y. And lastly, we add b squared, so we will have to square this. 3 squared gives us 9, and then we also have to square the y, so it will be just like this. This right here is the answer. There's nothing else that we can do. Do not factor this though, because this is actually not factorable. You can try it, but it's not. And let me just indicate this right here for you guys. How did we get this? It's because we square the 2x. So 2 squared gives us the 4, and x squared gives us the x squared. How did we get this? It's because we multiplied this and that. So 2x times 3y. And finally, how did we get the 9y? Square is because of that square. So 3y square. And then just remember the sign. If it's a minus, the first one it will be a minus, and this one right here will be a plus, and the last one right here it's a plus. Now for number 4, we have x to the 6th power plus 125y cubed. Here's the hint. We have the third power, right? So most likely we'll be doing the sum of two cubes. So to set up, we open two sets of parentheses with the third power on the outside. Now for the first one, we need to get x to the 6th power. So what goes inside? X squared. Good. Because we will have to multiply the exponent, x squared to the third power, 2 times 3 gives us the 6th power. Now for this, what to the third power will give us 125? If you say 5, excellent. We have the 5. And then we also need a y. Again, always set up. We have a sum of two cubes. This is the a, this is the b. Now, applying the formula, the first factor is a plus b, so it's just x squared plus 5y. And then continue, we will have to square this term, x squared squared. We multiply the exponents, so we have x to the 4th power. And then this is a minus. This times that, we will just have 5 x squared and then y. And lastly, we add this term square. 5 squared is 25. And then also do the y squared like this. This is it. This is the most that we can do. Okay. So again, this right here, it's because we have x squared and then squared. And then minus, this is because we multiplied this and that. So x squared times 5y. And finally, this right here is because of the 5y squared. All right, so these are the examples. Now, let me give you guys some practice questions for you guys to try. So here are the 6 questions for you guys to try. Make sure you factor them completely, meaning as much as possible. I trust you guys, you'll do it, right? Okay, leave the answer down below in the comment and let me know. So that way, I know you did it. That's it.